I had to stock up on more vitamins. Poor Chris, man. More work for Chris to go up and down. Up and down and work those legs. Work it, don't fall over. Don't drop the camera. Hey, look, guys. No headband. I'm feeling free. So what is up, you guys? Welcome back to Brick Me Up, Scottie. I'm Scottie Hoy. You're watching Bemus. First and foremost, thank you so much to Chris Chow for shooting me. Hi, Chris.
Hello.
He's actually been amazing because now he's starting to edit some of my videos. So that means more videos for you guys. So we got to get the likes going, more subscribers. Subscribe. So I'm bringing you more videos. Thank you for all the support. The store has been absolutely bonkers. Again, I have to apologize because shipping is just, you know, it's crazy in the world right now. Man, you guys just stay safe, build at home, buy sets wherever you want to buy them from. I'm just here to have some fun with you guys and review some sets for you. Today we're going to look at two sets. We're going back to Chinatown series. This is not from Xingbao, which I have been doing previously. I've actually skipped a couple of their series. And this is not Zigao, this is from Panlos. So let's just dive right into it. We're going to look at this one first, and then we're going to look at a new modular from them as well, from the same series. So what you're seeing in front of me is from Panlos. They actually don't name this. This is like a bunch of street stalls, a park. It's brand new, man. 610016. And it's roughly around 2,300 pieces. Yes, 2,000 pieces, and like half of it is all the minifigures, because there's so many figures that's on the set. This is the full set here on the booklet. I don't have the full set with me. I've only built this thing below me and one building. Chris is like, no, we got to get the other buildings. You guys really want me to review this for you? Really? Now they are a little bit pricier because these are like full-fledged buildings, man. Each one of these are like super huge, a lot of detail. When you put it together, it's going to be really, really big, man. Like, holy schmoly. But all the books are the same. They're super easy to read. If I go like that. So you have a choice, you know, you don't have to just buy this one. You don't have to buy that one. You just buy them individually. Or if you just want a little street scene, we start with this one. This is really, really cool. Chris is looking at this like, yo, it looks amazing with all the figures put on top on the set. If you're into like street stalls, or you have a bunch of symbol blocks that you have ordered from me or other places, and you want a little bit more of the street scene, this will go really, really well. This is amazing because I'm one of those guys that I'm not a designer. I don't know how to put my own things together. I just want to like buy and build. So with this, you're like, yeah, slap it together. You got a nice little street. You got a bunch of variations. There's so many things going on. If you're going to order the set, it's sent on multiple plates, right? So there has a bit of a bend or a flex. I was like, oh man. But I've seen that in every single order I've sent out. Once you tile it all together, it'll be totally straight and flat, just like you see here in the video. So the first thing we have here is this giant looking temple-ish entrance gate looking thing. It's a lot like Xingbao, seriously. It's like the rooftop kind of had that same vibe, same type of colors. Everything you see on this thing is printed. There's no stickers on this part, which is really cool. So all the lanterns, the middle piece there. So great detail on the gates, more printed text along the walls. And Chris says that just translates as like a good luck to the university students or honor roll students. Like, you gotta do as good as you can so you can enter this university. But the gate, like, meaning has nothing to do with this part, okay? It's like, just good luck. Good luck if you buy this set, basically. Yo, look at all the details right there. That looks so cool. I love the blue, I love the colors. This is already quite an outstanding looking set. Crazy, man, crazy stuff. You know, for the big entrance sign, you still have to be a little bit careful. It is sturdy when you're building it and putting it together. But man, if you lift this up on one side, this thing is going to totally fall over. So be very careful for this. The cool thing about the set too is they have studs everywhere so your figures can stand still. So if I like move this thing around, nothing's going to fall off. But there are a lot of loose pieces like fruits, vegetables, and all the stuff that you're going to see later can come off. So be very careful when you're picking this thing up. We got two figures there in the front. The figures look totally fine, but there's so many on this thing, we're just gonna whiz through them. You got a cameraman there, and you got a guy with a guitar. So it's modern, it's almost like a touristy type of thing. Okay, so I turned the figures there so you can see them more clearly. They look good. A lot of variations on the figures, they all look totally different from one another. And I like the design down below here, the bottom of the pillar, this design that was actually pretty cool. So that's the main entrance for you. And we start moving in. Let's walk through the pillars. So grandpa there is selling these cherry blossom looking flowers to this little boy here with the hat on. And behind them is a guy in a wheelbarrow. And the wheelbarrow has some watermelons inside it. That was actually pretty cool to put together. And see, he's on a stud, so it's not gonna flop all over the place. Boy, if this set had no studs, these guys would be like, this set would suck, like the last one. But I like the look of that. And then behind him, it's the fruit stall. The table, umbrella, everything's super easy to put together. The umbrella piece is actually a nice giant print, thank goodness. She's selling some fruit, you can totally rearrange it. And then just on the floor there, you can see some pineapples. Yeah, those are all stickers wrapping around it. Wah, wah, wah. So before we go to the next stall, you got two street lamps here. They look great. They have an illusion of like the trance clear or like lights, right? And the lanterns again are all printed there. Good luck. You're going to need it when you're going shopping. And then now we come to the next two stalls. The dumpling stall is actually pretty cool. It has a little fabric here from the roof, so a couple of these stalls do use fabric. Some of you like them, some of you don't like them. I think they're okay here in this exception. And the stalls are actually pretty well built. It might take some time to adjust to make sure like the poles are sticking out the right length. Got a little hat hanging there, and the sign that says, it's a dim sum shop. The figures look great as usual. You got the guy with his backpack, and the guy behind the counter has a little spatula for cooking your food. On this side, you got a vegetable stall. There's so many variations of what I think are vegetables inside each box. There's tons of little accessories. You know, you can add your own little things inside there if you wanted to. You got two more figures there. You got the lady that's selling the vegetables. She looks great. And you got a guy, or, well, no, maybe it's a guy that's selling the vegetables because he had the backpack sack on behind him with some veggies inside. At least I think those are veggies. So as we keep walking along, you got this guy here who's trying to get rid of all the ghosts. The ghost hunter. I like his sign. I think he looks really cool. And behind him, you have this carriage. There's a fabric there. Whee! And look inside. There's a character inside right there. Is she getting married or is she just going on a tour? Maybe she's going on a tour. The whole look of the thing is fine. Simple to build. Everything matches. I think there was a mistake in the manual. They put a replacement page that they'd used the wrong piece, but it's easy to follow. You'll know. This guy's like kind of drunk there up in there. That's pretty cool. Something that's different for change. We come to this section here. This is like a meat stall, but it uses real like wood, or is that like bamboo? But that top part is actually pretty neat. There's the employee in the back. My favorite part about this is the little French bulldog down there. I love that little doggy. All the meat that you see is printed. Everything looks really good. The style of the stall, again, different from one another. And you got this guy in the front who's trying to buy some meat. This side is the seafood restaurant. You got some crab and lobster there. This one has a very simple block feel to it with a rooftop printed pieces up there with a butterfly. And there's also some baskets and or like buckets here with water inside. Some clam, some fish, another printed umbrella there. Very cool stuff, man. This street is freaking long, yo. Then you come up to two ladies here. Little girl wants to buy some seafood maybe, or she's walking with her mama, who's holding an umbrella, who is next to this old man with a whip. He's about to whip their ass. I'm just kidding. I think he's walking his horse, so he needs the whip to like make sure the horsey follows him. Anyway, two more street lamps here. They are slightly different from the other ones, just on the top. And then we come to the last two stalls. This guy is selling medicine. And he has a little pole right here with a little fabric on there. This is pretty cool. And he has a golden monkey with a banana. That makes total sense. He's also playing an instrument in this medicine place. Got a little street performing thing going on there. Finally, you come to the very last stall, which is my favorite. Weapons, helmets. The amount of swords and spears and helmets, and each one is totally different and unique. It's great. You got even a parrot there and a guy working behind the stall. So this is the park section for you. I absolutely love it. But let's look at the next set, one of the buildings that I chose. Ready for this? So now what we're looking at is Panlos. They call us a gold shop. We're just gonna say gold shop. 610012, 2,551 pieces. So Chris wanted me to move a little bit faster and get this review out quicker. So this specific set I built here in the office, I did it one time, nonstop. For 2,500 pieces, it took me around 3 hours to put from start to finish with no interruptions. Yeah, around 3 hours, right? So there you guys go. So if you want me to do videos faster, I can. I just gotta sit here and build them and review them like right away for you guys. This was an amazing build, man. I actually had so much fun. But why did I choose this building out of all the other ones? because this one had more of an outdoor area. It had the tree. It kind of had different combinations. So I felt like, oh, let's just do this one first. So guess what? For this video, you guys can choose for me which set I should build next and review. If you want me to continue it, give me the order. There's five more to do. Five, four more, five or four, whatever. You can look on the store. Don't forget, these are available on BrickMeUpScottie.com. It does still remind me of Xingbao. They did the whole rooftop very similar. It's like they bought their set and went, yeah, we're gonna kick their ass and do something a little bit more different. So I'm just gonna rotate so you can visually see what it looks like here. Yeah, we're done with this video. Goodbye. It does come with some figures there. We will look at them later. I'm gonna move them all out of the way for now. We don't need to see them. I just wanna see the set. First thing here on the front. I think this is the front. There's actually two entrances, but yeah, I'm pretty sure this is the front right here. Dude, those lions are crazy. I love those. They're like individual pieces I've never seen before. But just to show you guys, you can split this thing apart. The stand is independent from the lions themselves. I was already blown away by this. I'm like, what? I've never seen this before. The front door is right there. Look good. They open and close just fine. Those are little stickers on the side of them. But up here, those are all prints. I was like, wow, those look really good. Next to the lion, you got a little kitty cat there with evil eyes. And the tree. I was like, oh, damn, trees again. This thing's gonna suck. But luckily, it's only two branches. Very easy to put together. It looks so good, so pretty. So I'm loving this front already. And I dig the window, man. It's like so old school style. You put that together and it just comes down and it holds up. Now we come over to this side, because this side is just as good as that side. And if you look on the bottom there, it's all tiled. And it's got a big hole, like a circle, which is very traditional, right? Now two plants there to put cherries on them. But hey, at least every single plant is slightly different. Putting it together, structurally, totally fine. Everything held in place. I was like, oh, this is a super sturdy set. I was so happy. And there's a lot of little decorations here. That's a different kind of technique I've never seen before. You got some lanterns hanging there on the side. Those are prints. This area is kind of like a chill area. It's got a little musical harp type instrument there. And you got a little bird. And he's like hanging on a little branch. He has his own water. And then you have the doors. They open and close just fine, like below. And those are all prints. Everything there. Wow. Very nice. I could sit here all day and just go like, buy me. Buy me now. You want this set. But is it detailed on the inside? We'll find out. Let's just look at the back of this thing, all right? So it's not crazy decorative on the back, but they still did the whole brick look here, and at least it's different colors. And we come to this side here, which is their staircase to go up to the second floor. And the staircase there, it's a little bit flimsy. If I go like this, oh yeah, when it was like kind of falling apart when I was putting it together. Once you stick them into their studs, they're totally fine. There's just a couple windows there, sideways fences, and a little barrel underneath there. And finally, you have a little hanging sign here. Chris was saying that the sign actually just says Gold Shop. Those are all printed, including the lantern. That was a nice touch. And just to show you real quick the fabric. Yeah, that's a piece of fabric right there. That's a little, oh, you go inside. And now it is time to look on the inside. So I'm gonna take this all off. Let's see if it comes off easy, okay? The studs are a little bit tighter than usual on the clutch, but look, it comes off easy. Yes. Okay, be careful for the sign because it's gonna hit the table, so I have to like kind of lift it up like that. So I'm gonna rotate it here real quick just to show you this little platform can kind of pop up and out like that. All tiled there. Yeah, they tiled everything in the set. Yay! Now it's a little bit more open. You can get your hands on the inside. You come to the escaping hole, or you come through the front doors. All tiled. Oh, so pretty. Look at all this detail. Holy crap. A lot of stuff going on in here, guys. There's two cabinets there. Interesting. They have rings on them, and they have like sausages for decoration, which is kind of funny. What's inside the drawer? You buy the set, find out. Let me know. It's for you. You enjoy that moment for yourself. Got two gold dragons. I don't know why they put those there. And some red decoration along the top. Well, that might have been a little bit too much. Anyway. And then there's a table in the middle. Look at those. They look like flower lightsabers. I don't know why they're using those pieces. But hey, that's cool, man. that's what you like. Then we come to the front door here. Above it, there is a sign. It's used a little bit of Technic pieces. I thought that was actually pretty cool, man. That is a print along the top of the door. I like that. And there's a cabinet here with a chicken and a seashell. Gold chicken. I don't know why. There's another sign along the top, and that was actually pretty fun to put together. And these little patterns, these circle patterns. This right here, oh, that's actually pretty cool, man. I like that. I was having so much fun putting the set together. I was hoping that this would be worse than Jigao, or like, nah, there's not going to be a lot of detail in this. This is not going to be so good. I enjoyed this more than the Jingbao stuff, man. Along this side of the wall, there's like more gold things, cherries and flowers. You got a flower vase there in the corner. It's just pretty simple stuff. Then we come to like my favorite part, which is the cashier area. They have an acabus, but it has its own stud, so you can just sit there. I'm like, whoa. And you got what looks like a gold hat, but actually that's old style gold. That's what it used to look like. And Chris was laughing because they actually put like a WePay or Alipay barcode scanner print there. So that's where you buy it from. So yeah. Even though this is like an ancient vibe, when you put it all together, you can see like tourists, the minifigures don't really match with this theme because it's like modern day, it's like a modern day museum type thing. That is a sticker of a scroll in the back there. Could have been a little bit bigger, but because they put the staircase and they're using this tree and it has a balcony area, this is a little bit smaller. The other ones that you've seen, or if you look at the site, are a lot bigger than this. So it'll be interesting to see how those ones look compared to this. Hopefully, they all don't look exactly the same. Now let's look at the second floor. Whoa, whoa. So of course when you do something like that size and the middle room is a little smaller, the second floor is gonna be pretty small. Let's see if this thing packs a punch. The rooftop is actually very easy to take off because they don't have studs to hold it down. It's okay, it would have been more secure if they held it down, but they did this thing here where they put these little pieces along the top so that it won't slide all over the place. So, just kind of a nice alternative. Now we look here in this room, I go bam, all tiled again. So you go upstairs, you walk through the flap, you come into this room. Yo, there's so much stuff going on in here. So this is like the jewelry or jade shop that you buy or you sell from. So you come inside, right in the smack dab middle, is this thing that looks like it's from Indiana Jones. Chris says that's an incense thing or a giant, it's like a giant pot. That's so cool, man. Now the treasure chest there, inside the treasure chest is a bunch of like items. You can just put whatever you want inside. Now along this wall here, there is a vase in the corner and there's a little cabinet there. Look at that shield looking thing. That's a print, man. And there's like two clear pieces with little flowers on them. That Chris was saying is jade. So very creative. Then there's another cabinet there with some gold pieces inside. Lots and lots of gold. And this is the door we saw earlier that goes out to the balcony. And just to show you, yeah, open and close is just fine. Look at that. That looks so cool, man. Okay, close this up. And yes, they put studs in there so you can stand your fingers up. You know, it's the small things that count. Okay, along this back wall is the prayer area. And look at that micro figure. I've never seen that. Chris and I were looking at that going, whoa, that's so cool. It's like a Chinese god, right? That you pray and you worship to. That was a nice touch. And there is a little sticker there on the side, like a famous kind of painting, the monkey. And then you come to this area here, which is just the tea area. But most of these places, even now, mainland, you can go into a shop and chill and have tea. It's like a very traditional thing, right? So you got two chairs there. Even the chairs are different from anything I've built. Those were a lot of fun to put together. And a little table there for your tea. Very, very small room. And I was putting this together, looking at Chris going, dude, this thing is actually pretty impressive, man. I really like this, man. Oh no, you guys are in trouble now. Time to spend more money to buy all this stuff. Put this back here, put the rooftop back on top. It looks just fine. It was fun to put together, a little bit repetitive. I love the little dragon sticking out there, and it is hollow on the inside. Cool, I like this. Now it does come with figures. Let's take a quick look at the figures. These are Panlos figures. They look familiar to you because they probably look like the guys in Royal Toy Sets. So you got this guy here, mustache, dressed up. Maybe he's the store owner. Printing looks fine on these guys, man. But there he is in blue. Then you got this guy who looks like a gangster with his robe on, but look, the printing actually goes over his leg. He looks really cool. I like his face. That's nice. Here we come to ladies. You got this little girl. I like her printing of the unicorn on her shirt. She looks just like my daughter. She's holding some snack. Maybe she bought the snack from the park earlier. There she is. Yeah, you see, you got this lady in red. She's very modern looking. She's got her handbag and she's walking in this place like, I'm gonna buy all the gold because I can afford it. And she looks fine, man. All these figures look totally fine, but you know, you can always replace them with your own figures if you're not happy with these ones. This lady here in green is more traditionally dressed up with a hairstyle like that. I like the printing. She looks really good. At least you don't have 100 figures like the other set. Each one of the buildings should have be like 4 or 5 figures that come with them. Now it's time for your dimensions. We'll start with the park first. Just so you guys know, there are 3 plates here and they are 20 by 32. So 32, 32, 32, 20 by 96. Yeah, this is pretty long. Don't pick it up here. And don't even pick this thing up. I have a huge long table, mini table that I slid this thing onto to carry it. It's the only way to do it because this thing will flop everywhere. But hey, it's all tiled at least, right? Okay, now break out your 1x4 bricks. I'll stack it right there. It's around that height. And that is around 23 bricks in height. Yeah, that should be the highest point. You can always take that off and make it totally flat. So the gold shop is on a 32 by 32 base plate. So you just need your 1x4 bricks. We'll stack it right there. Oh, it's almost there. It's kind of like 24 bricks in height. Oh, just a little bit over there. I'll make it work. 24 bricks in height for you guys. So whether or not this is for you, for your little touristy attraction, Japanese, Chinese, yeah, same, but different anyway. There you go, for your brick city. Okay, the video is finally complete. It's time to drop these things. This is gonna be a complete disaster, this one. Everything's gonna fly everywhere. You guys are gonna love this. This one, I hope, will hang in there. So you ready for this? Here we go. All right, so let's talk about this one because I just dropped this one. The rooftop was loose to be expected and some of the signs came off. Everything else seems okay. Inside wise, it's all intact. Just a couple of the bookshelves came off and on the first floor, nothing moved at all. So it's just a tree, the rooftop, easy to put on. Oh, the poor park is in shambles. It's like total nightmare. Actually, it's not that bad. It's just like a lot of the small pieces. Half the stall survived. I knew this part was gonna fall off, that's why be careful when you're putting on this piece. Now it's just all putting it back together again. There's your drop test. Yeah, let's get out of here. Rightio then. It feels very incomplete because this is only 2 sets out of all the other ones, and Chris is like, no, we gotta put all the other ones together so it looks really nice when they're stacked up. This one actually sits right here where it's supposed to. They have one more here, another one there, another one there. This will be really big, man. That's great. You can buy the whole set. And some of you have actually bought the full set without knowing how big it actually is going to be. You'll need a lot of room to do it. But that's really cool. That's like there, ready to go. And let me know what you think of this set. I think it's amazing. So you want me to do the other ones? Like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. Thank you so much for all your support. And it's time to work on the next video. So until next time, you guys, brick me out. Whoosh. They're gonna move the park here. Do not carry this thing, man. Pieces fell off this sucker when we were transporting it the other day. I'll leave it like that. Sorry guys, my throat's not quite perfect. Your B-roll for now, no, I'm just kidding.